Good morning and welcome. Thank you for joining us for the solemnity of the Ascension of the Lord. Our celebrant this morning is Father Darren Merlino. Please rise.
Good morning. Please join us in singing number 207, Praise to the Lord, number 207.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Today is the Solemnity of Ascension Thursday on Sunday. So let us call to mind our sins and ask our Lord Jesus for his mercy and compassion. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving. For the ascension of Christ, your Son, is our exaltation, And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the beginning of the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instruction through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them, but many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they have gathered together, they had asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the fathers had established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judah and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking up at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. All peoples, clap your hands, cry to God with shouts of joy. Sing praise with all your
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe. In accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the conclusion of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshiped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord. Personally, I'm very disappointed that we celebrate Ascension Thursday on Sunday, because it kind of downgrades Jesus' majesty as King of the universe and King of everything. And I really believe that it should be a holy day of obligation on Thursday. However, no one asked my opinion. But I really want to emphasize his kingship in our lives. But I also want to focus on something that we all experience. Who here was kind of baptized as an adult or over the age of reason, which was 7? Anybody? Okay, so this doesn't pertain to you. It pertains to all of us other Catholics. Because when we were baptized, we had godparents who spoke for us, right? We had, being Italian, we had the Godfather, and no, it was not Made After My Life, the movie. Or was it? But our parents and godparents spoke for us. And I'm a firm believer that baptism should be at when the baby is born. But what I want to emphasize, though, is the call that called to be a disciple of Christ. Now, we hear that so much as Catholics, like, oh, I got to be called to be a disciple of Jesus Christ, but what does that really mean? Well, I'm going to give you some stories what it means. So, I was a priest teaching at a high school, and one day, I guess it was a Holy Spirit moment, I was noticing that my Lutheran student knew more than my Catholic students. And I go, we'll call him Chris. I go, Chris, how is it you know the faith better than my Catholics? It was kind of embarrassing, actually. And he goes, I don't know. I just know all this stuff. I went to Catholic school my whole life, even though I'm Lutheran. And I go, hey, have you ever thought about becoming Catholic? Mind you, he's a very old freshman. He's what, 14, 15? So he clearly can't speak for himself because his parents still control his life until he's 18 and out of high school. I said, hey, Chris, ask your parents if you could become Catholic or not. Because I knew that he was going to go to 4 years of Catholic education. He was going to get a lot about Catholicism. So I figured he didn't necessarily need an RCIA program. So I just thought I'd ask. So typical freshman fashion, he doesn't tell me the answer. So I remembered 2 weeks later. I said, hey, Chris, so what did your parents say? He said, they said yes. You mean you can become Catholic? Yeah. Oh, okay. And I made arrangements for him to become Catholic. Then I all of a sudden, I was like, oh, all I have to do is ask? So I asked some more students, and their parents said yes. I had, by the time I left teaching, 5 years, mind you, I had 6 of my students get baptized Catholic. I had 2 teachers become Catholic. My boss's husband became Catholic. And I realized, wow, this is actually easy. All I had to do was ask. Now, this one was before I started teaching high school. I went up to my cousin. He was a 17-year-old at the time. Now he's in his almost 40. And I said to Dougie, hey, Dougie, if you ever become Catholic, I'm the one who's going to baptize you. And I wasn't even a priest a year, so I didn't even know what the heck I was talking about. So sure enough, 7 years later, he wants to become Catholic. He wants to marry his fiance, who is a Basque Catholic. So I said, okay. And he goes, so he went to the church and told the pastor, my cousin's baptizing me, and there's nothing you can do about it. So I ended up baptizing him. And it was the year, if you remember this, in 08, when Easter was so early. It was like March 23rd. So that's why I really, really remember that time. And so the more I realized that us Catholics, the easiest part of evangelization is the invitation. Every time you go to somebody and say, hey, you know what? If you ever decide to become Catholic or you want to come back to church, I will be there with you. I'll sponsor you if you become Catholic. I'll take you out to breakfast, lunch, or dinner after Mass. And every time you invite and pay for those meals or whatever, you're developing not only a friendship, but you're bringing a soul to Christ. You're actually fulfilling your obligation when you were baptized. We're mandated, not suggested, mandated to be disciples, to bring souls to Christ. Think about this. Those 12 people that I asked never would have been asked, and they might not have even gotten to heaven had I not asked. That was a lot of pressure for me now. It's like, oh my gosh, now I got to ask everybody. But think about that. If you keep your mouth shut and don't say something, you could affect somebody's eternal outcome, good and bad. We need to take this Ascension Day very seriously as Catholics. It cannot be a cultural event, baptism, first confession, first communion, confirmation, marriage, and then your funeral. As we say in theology, hatch you, match you, and dispatch you. can't do that as Catholics. And even as a priest, I can't do that. Even though I'm a highly paid professional, I still can't be the person who just is a sacramental priest. I just can't be that alone. And you know way more people in your circle, and I'll never, ever reach out to them. So when Jesus ordered them to baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, think about this. The first 12 minus Judas, then we got Matthias, so we'll take those new 12. We're literally the fruit of this event after Pentecost. Like, Pentecost happens, 3,000 were baptized the first day. We took us 2,000 years for Catholicism to get all around the world. And even it still hasn't really took root in Asia the way it should, like it has in Europe and South America. So we know we have a lot of work to do, and there's a lot of people. Think about this, almost 3 billion people of the 8 billion are Christian or Catholic or Orthodox. Those 12 got us to 3 billion, and we're not even at 50% of the world's population. That mandate is a necessity for Catholicism and Christianity to grow. Now, I personally believe that Catholicism is the church founded by Jesus. It's historical, it's documented, and it can be proven. So we know historically, objectively speaking, not my opinion, that Jesus founded our church. And we know he founded the sacraments, the 7 sacraments. The most popular, the Eucharist. The most least used, confession, which is one of the greatest forms of freedom I've ever experienced. We have the tools to become saints, and we have the best news of them all. We're preaching eternal life, heaven. There's only 2 choices, heaven or hell. We know that. Purgatory is not going to exist after the resurrection. It's basically that freeway is going to be demolished. Heaven, hell. Heaven, amazing glory, incredible experience. I mean, the joy that we can't even express the joy that heaven's going to bring us, because I have an amazing imagination for heaven, and my ideas are pathetic compared to God's. And you must have amazing ideas for heaven, and your ideas are terrible compared to God's. So we know for a fact that heaven is going to rock for all eternity. It's going to be an incredible experience, and we'll never die again. How are we not winning souls with this great message? Yeah, there'll be a cross here, 2 or 3. Of course, there's suffering in this life, but the payoff is amazing. And we can't sell that to anybody? What, because our moral rules are inconvenient for this world today? Hey, Jesus said, you got to pick up your cross daily and follow me. We all have crosses, but when you find meaning in that suffering, then all the suffering, I can endure all this suffering knowing that the payoff is eternal life with God. Because I know that this is temporary, not permanent. That is our mandate. We are told to preach that. Now you're saying to yourself, well, I don't know a lot, Father, about the faith. You're right, neither do I. So I go to Catholic.com, form.org, Hallow app. I mean, these are 3 excellent resources for us to get nourished and to preach the gospel. If you have questions, you can go to any of those websites and those programs, and you can learn more about your faith. Don't take the burden on yourself. Just say, I don't know, but I'll find out for you. Or you can join this app or join this, take this program or whatever it might be. We are so lucky as Catholics today. It's so much easier to evangelize than it ever was before. That mandate, I take very seriously. Now, I want you to come up with your list of people that you're going to have to go talk to. So after Mass last night at 5:30, one of your parishioners came up to me and says, you know, Father, you kicked me in the butt. All right, so now I'm going to go after my brother. So I'm going to put him on my list. I'm going to invite him, and he's number one on my list. He's the guy I'm going after. If you pick 10 people and just focus on those 10, you'll probably be busy for the rest of your life. But you are mandated. You cannot be a pew potato. You cannot just pay your fire insurance. You actually have to do something. Your Catholicism has to be active. The whole point of Vatican II was for us to be active in our faith, not just show up on Sunday. Sometimes I'll run into Catholics like, oh, I got to go to church on Sunday. I go, yeah, so do I. Well, yeah, you get paid, Father, to do that. Yeah, big bucks, huge. But I enjoy it. I enjoy the sacraments. I enjoy Catholicism. I enjoy the people. It's my greatest source of joy. And when somebody comes to confession for the first time in 20, 30, 40, 50, and 61 is my record years, I have more joy than anything. Because I know that God wins when there's a soul that comes back to Christ. Be Jesus to those who have left, those who are not part of our faith. I can't tell you how much it haunts me to think that if I had not asked those 12 people, those kids and adults at where I was working, where would they be right now? That would just freak, it just freaks me out. So why don't you be that person? Why don't you just ask those people and be consistent every week? Hey, I'm buying. And see what happens. The last story, came up to this one guy, he was a parishioner, and I said, Ken, when you become Catholic, I want to baptize you. I want to bring you into the church. I was pastor at the time. And he started to cry. We can do that. We should do that. Amen. Please stand for the creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. God has given us the Holy Spirit that we might be faithful disciples to all nations. With trust in his goodness, let us offer him our prayers this day.
For the church, may God continue to make us into his holy people who proclaim with zeal and commitment that promise of Christ to be with us always. We pray to the Lord. For those who had lead our communities, governments, and nation, may the Lord give them the strength to govern wisely. We pray to the Lord. for all who are sick, especially Annette O'Brien, Robert Luke Merce, Gloria Lee, Jonathan and Darby DeSilvia, and Darrell McNair, and especially those struggling with mental illness, and for those who care for them. Let us pray to the Lord. For all members of this faithful community, especially mothers that are being remembered at this novena at Masses, and our first communicants and confirmandi, we pray to the Lord. For the intention of Patricia Yum and Lilani Pia Kaido, we pray to the Lord. For the soul of the faithful departed, especially Robert Comer, Marino Antonini, Suzanne Van Dyke, Marie Casper, Anne Doe, Norm Slott, Charles Stanley, Ricardo Reardon, and Father Ron Talbot, may God, in his mercy, grant them eternal rest. We pray to the Lord. For the intention of the parishioners of St. Bede's Parish that are remembered at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Loving God, by ascending to your right hand, Jesus has restored to us the promise of eternal life. Hear and answer the prayers we have offered in his name. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to heavenly realms through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts. He ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Bede, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. There's a memorial mass for Father Ron Talbot. He is a Capuchin Franciscan from St. Francis High School, and that takes place at the St. Francis Chapel this Thursday at 7:30 p.m. There will be a farewell blessing for the old hall on Sunday, June 4th, after the 11 a.m. mass. Demolition begins as soon as the school year is completed. Now is the time to pledge, as we have a generous donor who's willing to match up to $700,000 of new pledges. This is a huge help to our parish. Keep in mind, May is a busy month. The St. Francis High School Baccalaureate Mass is here this Friday at 8 p.m. There's a community-wide interfaith baccalaureate service here on Wednesday the 31st at 7 p.m. for all graduating high school seniors and their families. That's people of all faith traditions service. And the St. Bede School Mass and graduation will be Friday, January 2nd. Congratulations and blessings to all the upcoming graduates. The Parish Center will be closed on Monday, the 29th of May, in observance of Memorial Day. Very important, crucial announcement, Parent Ed is hosting coffee and donuts. So make sure you stop by and get some coffee and donuts. Let's see, also special thanks to Father Darren Molino, who celebrated the Mass today, for our altar servers, our extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion, our lectors, our ushers, and our choir under the direction today of Dr. Lisa Thielen, because Tony is out at his son's graduation. So I thought the choir, they sounded pretty spectacular too. How about a big round of applause for everyone? Tonight we have our confirmation for, I think it's like 87 high school teens and one adult. And I think our high school teens especially need a lot of prayer. So I'm gonna ask everybody to join me and ask him for the intercession of our mother in heaven for these teens. You know, if you remember correctly, high school is not an easy time period in the lives of so many. So they need all the prayers they can get, just as we could have used them when we were in high school. So let us pray together. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Thanks for your presence, thanks for your support, and God bless you.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing our recessional hymn number 180, 3 days. We will be singing verse 3, number 180.